Welcome to the today's session. It's a paper, it's an elective paper that is food chemistry and biomolecules. The topic is mainly on this micro nutrients and macro nutrients. First, we shall take some macro nutrients already. Some part of this section I have completed. So that is three types of main macronutrients are there. That is carbohydrates, proteins, and lipids. As I told in the last session, this the carbohydrate is a function of carbohydrates, function of proteins, function of lipids. That all are you have come across, and I have explained in the last sessions. Briefly, I will explain. So, carbohydrates means you know, it's a source of energy, and this energy is used to day to day life. And the carbohydrates will break into this minor primary unit that is called as glucose. It's a glucose goes to the bloodstream, and as this glucose is the main source of energy. For example, the rice, wheat, and other cereals has this main component is carbohydrate. Next one is protein, second most required element. That is a protein. Protein is also with the carbohydrate. Protein also very important to our body for the cell maintenance and cell repairing, and the wastage of cell, draining of wastage of cell. That is actually the function of actual function of protein, and carbohydrate want to this function. For example, cell repairment or cell maintenance or cell development, all these aspects is done by only proteins. That is why it is also very important nutrient to our body. And next one is another case is another thing is lipid. So lipid is a minor quantity. If carbohydrate percentage is 70%, means the fat or these lipids, the requirement rate is about 5 to 10%, less than 10%. So, but the function of these lipids behaves as a storage of energy. It can store the energy, and when we do not have carbohydrates, this fat or these lipids helps to do the day to day life. That is why these lipids are very very important. And so mainly the functions of lipids are wound healing and blood clotting. In that areas, lipids are very very important. So blood clotting, so after wound, so blood clotting is very very important. For that purpose, lipid is come into picture. Others without lipids, it is very difficult. So it is a very good storage of energy, and this three nutrients we have to take in a certain limit, and carbohydrates, proteins, and lipids we have to take in a certain percentage Otherwise, it will be very difficult. If carbohydrates and protein is more, then also it will be problem. So for the digestion, it is problem, and so lipid also it's a problem, and so obesity will occur because of fat or lipids. That is why these we have to take in a certain limit. So if the limit crosses, means that will be a problem to our body. And next, some micronutrients are there. So micronutrients means with that macronutrients, micronutrients are very, very important. So micronutrients are mainly vitamin. You might have heard, so vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin C, vitamin D. What are the main functions of vitamin A, B, C or D? And what happens? We do not have those vitamins, means deficiency of vitamin A, what will happen because of your deficiency of vitamin D or deficiency of B or C, what will happen that you have come across already. And so in the vitamins, there are two types of vitamins. The first one is water soluble vitamins, and second one is fat soluble vitamins. Example for water soluble vitamins are vitamin B1 and B2. So vitamin B helps convert nutrients into energy. So vitamin B1, it's a micronutrient. So vitamin B2 means riboflavin. It also necessary for metabolic characteristics. So metabolism in our body, for the metabolism in our body, that is very, very important. And next one is fat soluble. So fat soluble vitamins. Fat soluble vitamins means, example for fat soluble vitamins are vitamin A and vitamin D. So vitamin A is very important for our vision, and vitamin D is for the bone growth. So these two micronutrients are helps to increase our bone activities and bone growths and vision. So for the eyes, it's a very, very important. And the students, in the next session, I will explain regarding the digestion of this micronutrients and macronutrients, and some other very important minerals and very important constant required for our day-to-day life is water and sodium chloride. That regarding water and sodium chloride and some aspects of digestion process, I will explain in the next session. Thank you.